So how many of you think that LeVar Ball just ruined his son's careers and life? Tell me yes or no in the comment section. And can you guys hit that like button? Let's get at least 1K likes. I appreciate everyone's support. But how many of you think that LeVar Ball just ruined LiAngelo and LaMelo's career and life? First off, let's break it down. LeVar Ball removed LiAngelo from UCLA because they suspended him after he stole from China. Now, from what I've seen, he had no problem with getting suspended. He knew he stole, he felt embarrassed, he knew he was guilty. Now let's move on to LaMelo. So LaMelo, he was in Chino Hills, playing great, but Chino Hills, they hired a new coach that LeVar Ball didn't like because the coach said, you know what, LaMelo, you can't be shooting all the time, you can't take crazy shots no more, you gotta be open, you gotta play defense. And LeVar Ball said, you know what, I don't like the new coach at Chino Hills, so I'm taking LaMelo out of UCLA. So do you guys see the problem here? The two sons, they didn't have a problem playing at the schools, but LeVar Ball had a problem with UCLA suspending LiAngelo after he shoplifted. And then he had a problem with Chino Hills hiring a new coach that didn't want LaMelo to be shooting from half court, not playing defense, taking crazy shots. Right now, LiAngelo and LaMelo, they're gonna play overseas as pros in Lithuania simply because their dad didn't get along with the schools that his sons attended. That was never in the plan. Now, LeVar Ball could have simply moved LiAngelo to another college. He could have simply moved LaMelo out of Chino Hills into another high school. But he decided, you know what, let me take my sons to play overseas. Now, Lithuania, they're not like the US. LiAngelo, he can't drive his Ferrari in Lithuania. LaMelo, he's only 16, playing against grown men. Now, of course, LeVar could have waited until LiAngelo was college ready and then he would play pro because then he's a man at least. But LeVar Ball took his 16-year-old son, who's still in high school, to play overseas in Lithuania against grown men. Now, you guys gotta remember, LaMelo, he was gonna be in high school playing against high school competition. And of course, colleges, they would have been like, you know what? He's nice. Bring him over here. We'll give him a full scholarship. And then he can work towards getting into the NBA. But when you're playing overseas, you're not playing against high school competition. He won't be playing against people his own age. He's gonna be playing against men, people that are grown. There is no 16-year-olds. There's grown men. That's a whole different world. That's a whole different situation. That's a whole different transition that LaMelo has to adjust to. Now, granted, if LaMelo does adjust to playing against grown men, then he's good. But think about it. LaMelo, he's only 16. LiAngelo, he's only 19. So they're still teenagers growing up to play against grown men. And you guys gotta remember, LiAngelo, he don't play no defense. LaMelo, he don't play no defense. So what happens when they gotta guard this grown man? LaMelo's gonna be playing point guard. He's gonna have to guard and be guarded by grown men. He's not pulling up from half court. He's not making no easy layups. I don't know how LaMelo's gonna handle that because he's only 16. He's gonna have to guard and be guarded by grown men. He's still so young. Why didn't LeVar just let him go pro after he finished high school? So LaMelo, he can't pull up from half court. He can't be taking crazy shots. LiAngelo, all he does is shoot threes. I don't know how great he's gonna be over there in Lithuania. And also, when you think about it, when we look at LeVar Ball as a father, as a person, LeVar Ball is the type of person that likes to control everything. LeVar Ball loved it when he could pull up to UCLA and he could say whatever he wanted and they'd listen and go along with it because his son Lonzo is on the team. LeVar Ball loved it when he could pull up to Chino Hills because he had his talented sons playing for them. They had no choice but to agree with whatever LeVar Ball suggested. LeVar Ball thought he could pull up to UCLA and no matter what his son did, he would get away with it. Just like how he stole in China, LeVar Ball expected for LiAngelo to not get any punishment. That's why he removed him. So we know LeVar Ball likes to control stuff. He likes to be in charge. Now, LeVar can't just pull up in Lithuania if LiAngelo and LaMelo, they're not getting the minutes that he wants them to get. And also, let's say that it's tough for LaMelo and LiAngelo over there and they don't like it. Think about it. They're moving overseas. They're not in the US no more. There is no McDonald's. You can't just hit up your homies like, hey, yo, let's chill. You can't do none of that. It's strictly wake up, you play ball, and whatever else they decide to do. Now, I don't know why they chose Lithuania. Maybe that was the only team willing to offer them jobs as pros. Because China, they didn't want LiAngelo because of his stealing incident. And even if China wanted LaMelo, LeVar Ball wouldn't have agreed to it because he wanted the two Ball brothers to play together. Now, what happens when they don't like playing in Lithuania? Does LeVar Ball take them off? Because if they couldn't handle UCLA and Chino Hills, they won't handle Lithuania playing against grown men. That's a whole different ball game. They signed a contract. But to me, I feel like LeVar ruined his son's lives simply because he removed them out of their situations simply because he didn't like how the schools were treating his sons. LiAngelo and LaMelo, they didn't have no plans to play overseas in Lithuania. That was never the plan. The plan was for them to get to UCLA and then enter the draft. And if they get selected, than the NBA. So we're going to see what happens. But I mean, you guys tell me what you think in the comment section, and I'm out.